Go ahead, Kunal sir.
Very good morning, Rama ji, and very good morning, one and all. Assalamu alaikum, Hasina ji, Sat Sri Akal, Jai Shri Ram. Very good. So nice to see you all. It seems sir is not with us today again, but as sir has told us that the show must go on and the conversation must go on. And this empowering morning conversation will go on today as well. So on behalf of Sukhdeepak Malwai, myself Conan Shahidi and Rama Zen, we all welcome you to another empowering morning conversation. And today is session number 235. That's great. And we are moving every day with the new thoughts, new understanding, and new process to create the chaos in our life and ultimately have the life which is nothing but ease, joy, and glory. So welcome once again and happy morning. So we'll start another conversation today, but just to remind us, what do we do here? And in simple words, what do we do is to shift ourselves from the default mode to the create mode. So under the default mode, as you all know, once upon a time we used to be there, and I'm sure now we are not there. At least we are shifting. I think some of the guys, Rama or some of the others, they have already shifted. Nitiji has already shifted. So we are in the process of shifting ourselves from the default mode to creation mode, to create mode, where we have the power to choose. And we are aware, we are attentive, we know what's happening within me, outside me, and then we can choose whatsoever we want to choose. And as sir has always told, default mode is nothing but the mode where we stay and we stay with the resistance. We stay with the reaction without thinking. We complain to the people, to the situation. We blame to others. And all such negative effects, because we live in the world which is full of negativity. And as sir always said, that bombarded with the negativity. So we have to not only survive in that, but we have to thrive. And when we have to thrive, we have to create. We can't just be in the mode of default and reacting and resisting and losing all our energy. Instead of, we have the power to create and choose. So that's what we do every morning here. So let's start another empowering morning conversation, and let's start another day which is full of opportunity, full of abundance, full of all the elements which will give us the life. As sir says, that all of life comes to us with ease and joy and glory. And for that, we are learning new tools. We are practicing. Even though sir is not here, we'll practice it, so that we rediscover ourselves. And when we rediscover ourselves, our potential, then we can choose whatsoever we want to choose to have a wonderful day. Right, so let's start the conversation. And with that, I'd like to welcome you again. Ramaji, over to you. Niti ma'am is also ready. Reddy Garo is there. Hasina ji, Gopal ji, Gautam Buddha ji, Gautam Bhadra ji. All are on camera. And some of them are not on camera. So if you're comfortable, be there. But if you want to be, come on camera, please do come. Start conversation, share something, so that we all learn together in this journey. Right. So thank you so much. And over to you, Ramaji. Back to you.
Thank you. Thank you, Kunanji. Good morning. And before we start the new topic today, if anybody would like to share about last few days topic, what's your what's going on with you, specifically on freedom, chaos, and few other things what we have been talking about. If you have anything to share, please go ahead and share.
If I may, Ramaji, Or maybe Prasad Garu want to say something?
Yeah, Reddy Garu wants to say something.
Reddy Garu. Go ahead, sir.
Sir, good morning.
Good morning.
Sir told one of the classes, don't be pushed by your problems, by your dreams. This is making not to think about whatever we are learning here, sir. See, I'm always going into a default mode. I'm trying my best to get back into creative mode because we are always pushed by our problems. So then because of that, our dreams are going back because we just try to make up for the situation at the moment. That's what I feel I'm facing. I'm trying my best whenever the awareness, with our awareness by attending the classes and with the sharings from all of you, I'm trying my best to be in awareness. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. So awareness is most important. We have to know what's going on within ourselves and around ourselves. And the other one is attention. By default, in default mode, the attention goes to the problem and negativity. So here we are all learning how to take attention under our control and put that attention in what we want, which is either solution for the problem or something new to be done or something creative. So that's what we are doing here. Thank you, Reddy Garu, for sharing that. Yes, Kunanji.
Can we ask Reddy Garu to elaborate what he mentioned, sir, so that we can, we all can understand and maybe we can share our thoughts on that.
Yes, sir. I'm very clear. The problem here is, for example, I'm giving a very real example. I'm attending this everyday morning classes and I'm making a note, but I'm not able to follow or think about it on the day, during the day. That's my issue. Because okay. I'm bogged with all the situations and problems still.
Okay, so what I'm getting from this, that though you know the tools, you have written it down, but yes, when the real situation comes, yes, when the reality of life comes, as sir said, that the real life, not the real life. So when the real life situation is there, your mind doesn't bring these learnings and make into the practice, or you don't think it is possible to practice. Something happens which you are not able to implement it, isn't it?
I'm able to implement it partly, sir, not fully.
Not fully.
Awareness is not fully.
Let's listen from Gopalji, because I remember a couple of days back, Gopalji has told that he has implemented and he is managing the situations. Gopalji, would you like to share something on this?
Yeah, I think awareness is the key thing, you know. And this is a practice you have to do consciously every time. See, like, for example, as I told yesterday, that every few minutes, you know, for half an hour or 1 hour, you pause and keep thinking what is going on in your mind. And then consciously, you change that to right direction, you know, if you want, where you want it to go. That means from, because mind is like that, you know, keeps on wavering, you know, you never know, because we have been used to it, you know, we are just learning it to control it and bring it in our, what we want it to do, where we want it to go. So this is very important that we become conscious, and awareness is the key to everything, you know, once we become aware. And be in the present, you know, that is also an important thing, you know. We normally 80% of the time we're in the past and 10% time we're in the future, hardly about 5% we're in the present, you know. So we got to be in the present and be aware what is going on. And I suppose that is the key to everything.
I think very profoundly explained. And this comes with the practice. Yeah, this will come with the practice. Let's listen from Niti ma'am also on this issue. Maybe some insights will let you think on this subject, Prasad Garu. Niti ma'am, what's your thought on this?
Thank you, sir. I think Gopal sir has very well explained it. It is only, and Reddy sir has been talking about implementation of these things. He has been doing it at certain levels. I think his drive is to do it at a much bigger level. It does take time, and it does take this conscious thinking that he's coming back and sharing. He's doing this conscious thinking. So I think he's on the process. He doesn't have to feel pressured by it. It's just that, you know, every morning we are refreshing ourselves, and if we keep a little effort, if we put a little effort in keeping our mind open whenever we have a free moment, whatever we are thinking of at that moment, just stop and keep our mind, make our minds a little more open, these tools and these learnings will become part of our daily functioning at every moment of time. So I don't think Reddy sir has really anything much to be worried about. He's already on the path.
Oh, yes, definitely. He will become conscious of it slowly.
That's true.
On a lighter note, I just want to tell you, earlier I used to say Om Namah Shivaya always whenever I feel disturbed. Now I'm saying all of life comes to me with ease and joy and glory.
Wow.
Yes.
That's a great shift. Let's listen from Suresh Garu also some tips for you, Prasadji.
Good morning, everyone. This is not the tip. I'm just sharing my point of view about this. Like, I mean, if we compare two cars, any car, Maruti or Mercedes, anything, you know, as long as the vehicle drives smoothly, we drive the vehicle very smoothly, no problem. I mean, we reach the distances, I mean, areas and all that. When the trouble comes, then only we open and see. Okay. I mean, that is a process, what I think. I mean, when you are in a process, you will do many things. And when there, if any problem occurs, then only we will stop there and look for a solution. This is what I'm thinking.
We can be a little bit more proactive, that we know that it is going, that there is going to be a problem, because if
car yes, sir. Even if it is there, see, unless there is a problem, when if we get problem, then only we will find out the solution. Otherwise, things will move smoothly.
No, we have to give the car for servicing once in a while, right? Even if it
is that's what I mean. See, there is a program, like, okay, you have to give servicing and you have to change the oil and all that. Similarly, we in our life also, things keep on moving, and the petty things we will probably, you know, take care. And when there is a major struck is there, then we will stop there and because it will not allow us to, you know, move further. Like a speed breaker will allow us on the road, you know, you can cross the speed breaker and go. And if there is a wall on the road, you cannot cross. So big problems are like walls. We have to look for an alternate. So, yes, sir.
I think it makes sense. Let's listen to the other perspective. Gautamji wants to share something.
Yeah, just one point on Sureshji, what he said. See, if there is a wall, that is understandable. Even a small speed breaker, we think that there is a major problem and then turn back or take some other route instead of really going where we want to go. So,
yes, sir. Yeah.
Right. Yes, sir. Please go on, Gautamji, Kunanji.
Yes, good morning, everybody. In my life, when we see any, somebody has asking, it is a problem with everybody. I don't know a problem with everybody. It is a problem with me. Like Gopalji just told, that is, he overcome this problem. He makes his mind and he try to avoid this type of hindrance, disturbance in life like that. So It is a morning impairment. It help us to bring back to a right direction. But after evening, in the night, almost we are, to me, I'm talking about my feeling or my thinking. We are diverted again. We are going to think, going to that old and negative mood, thinking all bad things about dreaming something is happening wrong. I don't know why. Everything is smooth, everything goes smooth. And you are rightly told that is Ramaji, that is seeing the little barrier, or we are thinking it is a big one. And we divert and take the different route. But, how to control every day, or how many times we have to do the practice? This is that is very important for me. So, please guide us. Please guide me, Gopalji. How we can do? How many times in a day we can do this? Practice the tools to come on the maintain the ease, joy, and glory. Thank you.
So you are in the journey, and definitely you will reach there. Just a matter of time. So let's listen from Nitiji.
I just wanted to add one more line, taking the same example of a car that Suresh sir has brought up. Like when we are in the car, when we're driving the car, the road is bumpy and we go over the bumps. We are more focused on how badly we went over this bump or this broken road or this turn. But we forget in this whole journey of going over bumps, the skill of our driving eventually gets polished.
Mm.
So keep that in focus. It's not always a question of the accelerator or the brake. Half clutch, but badhiya gaadi aise raaston se nikal gaya. That's all. Thank you.
Great one.
Sir, actually, I wanted to say something. Like, see, the minor things keep on happening when we are driving on a road. साइकिल वाला आ जाता है, स्कूटर वाला आ जाता है, ऑटो वाला आ जाता है. दे आर प्रिटी थिंग्स, यू नो. वी आई मीन इफ वी बट दोस वी हैव टू जस्ट अलाउ देम, यू नो, लेट देम गो, देन वी कैन पीसफुली वी कैन गो. इफ वी थिंक, यू नो, अरे व्हाई दिस फेलो हैज कम और व्हाई दैट ऑटो वाला हैज कम, आई मीन दैट इंक्रीजेस अवर स्ट्रेस एंड इट विल नॉट अलाउ अस टू, यू नो, गो फर्दर. हमेशा गुस्सा में हो जाता है ऑलवेज. सो इट्स बेटर, okay, let them go and we can go properly, you know, like kabhi kabhi ruk ke bhi jana acha lagta hai. I mean, it's better what I feel.
Yeah, makes sense. So it's very interesting conversation. Let me share my thought and then request Ramaji to take the session forward for the new questions and the new thoughts of the day. So what I learned from this conversation, as Rama sir explained, the attention is very important. And sir has given the tool. I don't know whether Prasad Garu is practicing or not. Attention exercise, you must keep on doing, sir. Looking at the 50 objects and looking in one direction and having attention in other direction. Because this attention exercise will help us to be more attentive during that situation where you are unable to recollect and implement or use the tools or manage the situation in a more pleasant way. And other thing what I have learned, I wanted to share that any situation whatsoever happens, and when we feel that it should not have happened, so basically it is just a situation. Sometimes the root cause of the problem is somewhere else. So as Gopal sir mentioned, give a pause, stop your mind for a few seconds and just reflect upon that. Is the situation is the real problem, or the root cause of the problem is somewhere else? And what happens in the life, that any situation, it becomes real problem, or we think it is problem for me because that situation in that moment is not as we desire or as we expect or as we feel it should be. So again, sir has given a tool that, okay, this is an interesting situation, and this experience, what I am learning from this experience, because all the situation, sir has told, is from the universe, to give a pause and think how I can become a better person by managing this situation or this problem or this moment. So experience the experience. Again, the issue will come that how aware we are, as Gopal sir mentioned, and as Niti ma'am also explained, that you have to be, keep on understanding of the specific situation and finding the ways with the skills. And as Suresh Garu explained, that yes, there could be many people coming on the way. So if that situation with the involving of some people, consider they are all are one. We all are in the same journey, and oneness, again, sir has given us wonderful tool and examples to how do we feel that we all are one with the allowance. So if we think that we all are one and we allow others to express the opinion, the views, whatsoever, and then tell ourselves that it is interesting point of view, my view in that moment, an interesting point of view of the other person in that moment. So then the feeling of oneness comes, and then the feeling of ease and joy comes, because we all are one in the same journey, same path. So that way, I believe with the practice, because the journey, we are learning and we are moving forward. And with the time, I believe what I can see that Prasad Garu has already transformed his life in many ways. Maybe certain more things with the practice will definitely be, will make you more powerful individual and more, as sir said, that we all are magnificent and extraordinary human being. We deserve to be loved and respected. It's just a matter of time, sir. So, Prasad Garu, would you like to reflect upon, is this conversation helping you or in any ways, what's your thought on this?
Thank you, sir. I think your sharing is definitely helpful to me. In fact, when the situation arises, I'm always sending back saying that this is not my problem. I'm returning to you. That I am already following. Thank you, sir.
Sir, actually, I want to share another thought of mine. I mean, related to this. Like when we are driving, I mean, only I'm taking this example. You know, road is always not smooth. Sometimes, you know, it is bumpy. Sometimes it is a ghat road. Sometimes kabhi pani bhi aa jata hai road ke beech mein. So, when it is a bumpy road, Mercedes and Maruti both run at the same speed because they have to be very safe. Once the road is open, I mean, Mercedes will show its power where Maruti cannot, or Ambassador cannot compete with Mercedes or anything. And in a traffic, like a city like Mumbai or Hyderabad, if there is a traffic, Maruti ko bhi rukna padega, Mercedes ko bhi rukna padega. So, looking at the things appropriately and moving out, that will help us to, you know, not losing the temper. Because things are not under our control. Only we have to control ourselves, our anger, our emotion. This is what I feel.
Yeah, and of course, we have to take insurance from you also. Thank you, Suresh.
Thank you. Thank
let's
you.
Listen from Mallika ma'am. After that, Suchitra.
Sir. Good morning, sir. For me here, good evening. I'm coming to that three examples given by Rama, first of all, that is about the speed breaker. I am taking this speed breaker as a process in whatever, in our life or in workplace. So in the speed breaker, there should be supposed to be three white lines. There should be a white line so that when we come in the long distance, that is half kilometer or half for long before itself, we can identify that there is a speed breaker. But we cannot see this line, this white line everywhere. Normally, especially in streets or in some roads, we cannot see the white lines on the speed breaker. So that is a process. If the process in place, we can able to drive properly. Accordingly, we can plan accordingly. But it is not as per the process. That is one thing. So which is, we cannot able to plan our driving, whether there is a speed breaker. And when we tell about this, when walking on this, when walkers come, so here in US, even though they come speed, there is normally, it is not in highways. Highways, we have to take care. If it is not in highways, in other places, they used to give respect to the walker. Even they in highways also, if there is a zebra crossing, and if more people are waiting on there also they are giving respect. So that we have to follow in India. So two things. One is we are, for the drivers, we have to keep everything in process then only. And one more is that instead of the speed breaker, there may be some, the road will not be as sir previously told. The road may not be in the, am I not audible, sir? Okay. So may
you're
not,
audible.
So
yeah.
So sometimes it will be digs will be there. The proper road will not be there. So there also, there will not be any sign at all. So we don't know whether we have to adjust our speed or not. That is also there. So all the three things, we have to take it into consideration. So if there is a trespassers, zebra cross, then we have to give the respect to the trespassers. So that is also there. Thank you so much, sir. This is my opinion. I just share my opinion here.
Thank you, Malika ma'am. And this is what sir has told us, that life is also like, we all are the driver of our own life. And it's a great analogy to understand our life with a car. When I am a driver of my car and there's a path, various stoppers, various barriers, various obstacles, and many others coming with other vehicles, and there is a disruption and lack of discipline of the traffic. So this is what sir has told us, that we all are the driver of our life. And there are many people are the co-drivers with different vehicles, with different purpose and different objectives. So here comes the practice. What we do is the allowance, as Malika ma'am explained. And here also in UAE ma'am, in Dubai and Sharjah and other places, if we are driving and someone is crossing the road by walking, normally the drivers, they stop and let the other walkers, they go. And this is what life is all about. We have to be in allowance with others to understand that, yes, I am the driver. There are many others also are moving in this journey with me. So how I have to manage my life? By be attentive, be aware, be careful with the love, compassion, and thinking as a collectively with oneness, and keep on moving, having the life with ease, joy, and glory. And that's what we practice every day, every morning with Mr. Sukhdeepak Malway, so that we keep on learning all the tools and we become the real skillful driver of our life, so that right. We don't make any accident.
So talking of driving, Kunainji and everyone else, so the minibus we are driving right now, we are going to stop here and get into a train. So Cyrus published another link. So he's talking in another forum. So we are all going to join there. So the link is there in Morning Conversations. So we will leave this and jump on to that bandwagon.
Okay.
So
we'll all see you there.
Yeah. Thank you, Malika ji. Thank you, Sagar. Let's be
please
there.
Please join the other link, which I just now sent.
Okay.
Thank you so much. That's more important, guys. So let's be there. Take care.
Right. Let's be there, everybody.
Right. See you there.
See you there.
Do you want me to put the link here?
Yeah. Better.
Yeah, better.
Please, sir.
In the morning conversation, that link is in the group.
I mean, other is where
it's there in the group also. I put it here also. So you can click from here and go.
Okay.
please click the other link which is there in chat and go there, or exit and then use this. Priya, join the other link. Ashokji, join the other link. I'm closing this.